The future is knocking and the Creality K1, let's heat this up on the table, then for me, comment box if this time is good or Creality needs to be so printed this Christmas. I have made a mistake. This is Creality K1. Good evening. Today we are going to uncover the hidden truths and secrets about this brand new Creality K1. So without any further ado, let's unbox it. Unboxing is straightforward. As we crack open the box, the first thing that catches my eye is an updated extruder with slick white cap. The older extruder with a black cap has some issues. Inside the printer, we get a cable, attachments and a toolbox. The first impression of a printer is really premium. Let's see what's inside the box. Here are some cards, stickers, and manual with all languages. Screen for the printer. The spool holder is the same as the Ender 3. Some rubber feet to deal with vibrations. This is a hyper PLA from Creality. Inside the box, there is a blue grip plier as always, a wrench, a plastic scraper, metal grease, a big needle, glue stick, double coated tape, a nice USB drive, and some tools. We need to install this knob for the glass door. It comes with a screws and steel plate. I have made a mistake. This steel plate needs to face outwards the printer, not inwards, so it stick to the frame magnets. We need to unscrew these three screws. It only dare to not damage the build plate while transporting the printer. Also remove this protector from the build plate. Time to install a screen. Carefully attach the ribbon cable to the screen. After that, push the screen into the printer slot and pull down. I have got an issue. My screen has become an obstacle while opening the glass door. Also, I have noticed that the top right corner of my glass door has a little gap. I push down the screen little bit more and it works. Let's install these anti-vibration rubber feet. Now it's time for a spool holder. Also adjust this voltage before turning on the printer. Here is the hyper PLA that comes with the printer. Cut the PLA angle. While pushing the PLA through the PTFE tube, make sure to unlock the extruder and push the PLA all the way down. And then lock the extruder. We are almost ready to bring this beast to life. Here is a Creality logo and the K1 is awakens. Some instruction and initial setup. Find your Wi-Fi and connect it. Also find your time zone and select it. This is a self-inspection. The printer will automatically check everything and also calibrate automatically. calibration done. We can also use this upper cover for printing ABS or PETG materials. Let's explore the interface. We can turn on or off LED light. Also, we can control all fan speed. Extrude and retract option. We can control our axis here and also have a nozzle and a bed temperature control. This is a folder where all our 3D print G codes from local directly through Wi-Fi, from USB drive and history of our previous prints. In this setting tab, we can adjust screen brightness, screen off time, self check. Also, we can root the device. From here, we can directly connect to the Creality Cloud. So let's bring my phone and connect it. This is a Creality Cloud app. Pairing is easy. Click on Add Device, select the printer, scan the code to connect the printer. Here we can adjust the temperature of the nozzle and bed. Start print option, or there is an option directly print from Creality Cloud. Other settings like extrude, retract, move axis and so on. Move to our settings tab. If you have a Creality AI camera, then you can control it from this tab. This is an error tab. We can get details of our previous errors. Really convenient. Let's print our first 600mm print. I don't want to calibrate again. Printer had done that job. After a few moments, it started. The first layer is done silently, and then the second layer is jaw-dropping. It's like watching a 3D printing superhero in action. 600mm speed is really fast. Creality did a good job. After a few minutes, the job done. Look at this, it has no under or over extruded layers. Let's insert our generic PLA and test the 16 minute preloaded benchy. This one also came out perfectly. Only a minor layer issues, but overall it is perfect. But wait, there is more. Let's slice the first model. The USB drive comes with a printer that has PDFs, STL files and a slicing software for K1. So I have installed a slicing software. The slicer is easy to use. If you want me to make a full video on this slicer, do let me know in the comment box. I'm using this all-in-one test for printing with a generic PLA and 300mm speed. This one also came out good. This line is only because of power loss issues, but on the model, stringing, bridging, diameter, all tests came out perfectly. I have also printed this Christmas tree for testing interlock, and guess what? This one has also passed the test. This printer have some pros and cons, some nice features. Number 1, speed. The Christmas tree I have printed only takes 4 hours and 42 minutes with 300mm speed. But if I printed this on Ender 3 V2, you can see it takes 16 hours 18 minutes time with 50mm speed. So the difference is really big. Let's put the light on the other pros of this printer. Number 2, frame. The printer has a premium and high quality frame. But like any superhero, the K1 has its kryptonite, the interface. The K1 interface is really smooth. Also, we can set the nozzle and bed temperature from the home screen. These type of shortcuts makes this interface more user-friendly. Number 4, AI camera. It has the option to install AI camera and LiDAR sensor. I have not purchased that yet. I like to make a separate video on that in future. So stay tuned. Number 5, connectivity. This printer supports Wi-Fi. So we can print on this printer through the LAN network and directly from Creality Cloud. And if nothing is working, we still have a pen drive option. But this printer has some cons also. Number 1, it vibrates a lot. It has an input shaping option, which helps to reduce the vibration, but it still has some vibrations. The first 600mm print I have done with this, it vibrates my whole wood table. Number 2, the glass door hinges are too small and it feels like you made just one mistake while opening that glass door. It just came out and will fall down. The same thing happens with Uncle Jesse. Also, the glass door is not open wide. It only opens 90 degrees. So we need to be careful while opening the glass door. Number 3. It has a jet sound. Yes, Creality K1 fans are loud. Especially the side fan. While printing, or if we set the side fan on 100% from settings, you can hear it. I understand that this is for cooling down the plastic faster while printing fast, but it is loud. Number 4. The spool holder is on the back side. So if we place the printer on the table facing the front side, then it may be difficult to reach the spool holder. In my case, this same thing happened. I placed the printer on the table, then for me, it is difficult to reach the back side of the printer. But it's not a big deal. The good thing is that we only need to hang the spool and just push it through PTFE tube. That's it. I will make a video on Creality K1 mods and upgrades, so stay tuned. Number 5. They need to focus on their Creality Cloud. It had some bugs, sometimes difficulties to connecting to the printer, and also a lot of ads. I hope in the future they may update it. This printer is not an open source printer. It's just a plug and play machine. You cannot install your firmware or any other parts into the machine, at least not for now. In future, Creality will might be give us open source access for this machine. Now, let me spill some secrets no one is shouting about. The nozzle. It is a speedster, heats up very quickly. Let's run a small test and see the results. I have a stopwatch. Now the nozzle temperature is normal. Let's heat this up to the 300 degree. See, it only takes 1 minute seconds to heat the nozzle to 300 degree. It's really impressive. Now let's see how much time it will actually take to start printing the first layer after giving the print command. Let's calculate and see the results. I have turned off the calibration. The printer homes the axis, heating up the nozzle and bed, clean the nozzle, and after that start its first layer. And it takes 4 minutes 11 seconds. Do let me know in the comment box if this time is good or Creality needs to be reduced this. Just unbox the printer, remove the 3 screws, insert a filament, turn the printer on and start the first print. The future is knocking and the Creality K1 is answering with a simplicity with speed. In my humble opinion, Creality created a masterpiece of a 3D printer. Premium build, rapid speed and touch of magic. It's fantastic addition to any workspace. This printer has also a bigger option, that is K1 Max. If you have a budget, then go for it. Whether you are a seasoned maker or diving into a 3D printing for the first time, K1 is worth the journey. If you want to enter a 3D printing world, then hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Happy printing.